Okay, guys, we're going to get started. Second match of the day, and this is from the one loss side. It's Jason Osborn versus Joe PG, a.k.a. Snooker Joe. Oh, this is a winner's side match. Okay, sorry about that. We got Snooker Joe PG, former owner of the Four Cas Room here in Las Vegas. And Jason Osborn, the better half of Stacey Alsup. And he actually was the winner of last year's Doc Hill tournament, if I'm not mistaken, maybe last year or the year prior. This is the Tiger Sin City Tour, and this is day two, the final day. The final 18 players. We tried to get it down to 16. So the matches are only going to get better from here, folks. And also, just for your general interest, the Gary Onimura, you just saw him play Smitty. He lost pretty bad. But they're going to be hosting at Good Times Billiards. They're going to be hosting the second tour stop of the Sin City Tour. That'll be April 2nd and 3rd. April 2nd and 3rd, guys. Stop number two. Stop number two of the Tiger Sin City Tour will be April 2nd and 3rd. And you can find out more about the Tiger Sin City Tour on my website. You just simply check out the announcement about the Tiger Sin City Tour, or you can click on the link in the chat room. Go to POVPOOL.com and you'll find out more about the Tiger Sin City Tour. Stop number two is going to take place April 2nd and 3rd. So let's get this match started now. Joe is going to break, and he goes to seven. Soft break. Yeah.
Plus, you know, if you want that director of marketing job.
So, with that soft break, I can understand this strategy. Is soft break. The way he played this soft break, in essence, is kind of like a safety break. Well, I was hoping we'd see Joe Klimchuk here today, but I don't think he's in. We had Joe Klimchuk here all day yesterday, and Joe Klimchuk will also be at the Andy Mercer tournament coming up. He'll be at a couple of the other tour stops on the Tiger Tour, so be sure to make good friends with Joe Klimchuk, and he'll hook you up with a tip for your cue or do some cue maintenance for you. Nice of him to come in and do his whole lathe setup at every venue. Mm-hmm. What just happened? So, yesterday we did a match with Joe versus Glenn, and it was a pretty long match, and it was late in the evening. That being said, and judging by the first couple of opening shots from Joe, I'm guessing we're going to have a long match. He's a real tactical player. He's a style of play that can wear down a gunslinging nine ball player. Guys like Al Lawrence and Donnie Branson would generally be able to work, you know, with Joe's style of play, but a lot of these gunslingers that have problems with safeties and aren't familiar with the table angles and cue ball control might have a problem playing Joe. Foiled by his own plan. Boy, and he had ball in hand there. Yeah. Anyway, Jason's looking at a little more open table here, but he's got to kind of work with the close quarters of all these balls. So, you know, when you get a table layout like this, a lot of times you got to play short side of the ball, which is what he's doing. He's manufacturing shots that are kind of closer to the short side. And once again, that's exactly what Joe's break will do. The break that he played to open up this game. Wow. Jason is not showing the player. He's not showing a lot of patience. Went for that combo. But that's the kind of game Joe's going to play on him. He's going to try to frustrate him. Nice shot. Uh-oh. He got titty hooked. He got... Well, no, he didn't. That looks like a titty hook to me. Wow, he got away with it. Uh-oh. Okay, so... In this situation, you might see a lot of players just playing the bank on the seven. A lot of very strong, very skilled players. But I'm going to predict that Joe plays a safety. The safety could go wrong, though, either way, when you come across the top of the seven or if you come underneath the seven to try to play cue ball under the nine. Both these safeties are missable. So there you go. Jason can see a little bit of this ball. What's he looking at here? Okay, so it looks like he might be thinking about coming off the rail first and then playing the cue ball off the seven into the eight. That's such a low percentage shot. Yeah. Such a low percentage shot. You know what? You got to roll. I'm not sure this. I think the scratch is on. If he plays the seven in the corner, the scratch is on. The bank is available. You guys see that? You can bank this one rail in the corner. You may have to go for this, Joe. I like hitting this firm. And maybe stun run the cue ball so that... If you come across the short rail with the seven and the seven comes around two rails up table again, then your cue ball is down over by the nine. Wow. Yeah, I don't think he played to make that. I'm not sure he did. Not sure he did. So Jason made this seven and he's kind of in trouble here. Wow, he played that shot. Boy, oh boy. Joe's lucky day. Snooker Joe gets on the board. Nice break. The one's up table. The cue ball's over by that nine. But I think he can see it. I think the shot's on. He hit it thick. And he opened the table, too. So, only problem I see here is the four ball down by that nine, but not much of a problem. The three ball is close to the four, so might be able to play a breakout. Wow, he cinched the one in the corner. Now he's cutting this two. Let's take a look at the angle here and see what he can do. He's going to, yeah, I don't mind playing this two ball. You're going to cut this thin and play this two ball. A little bit of outside English on the cue. And then bring your cue ball two rails across. Maybe you land near the seven ball. And then you've got a good angle to break out the four. But here we go again. Joe is going to play safe. Which is also a very valid shot. How are we doing now? Three ball available to the side pocket there. With the seven in the way, he won't have the four to the corner or to the other corner. Another safety. Yeah, believe it or not, I think he was playing safe. He was trying to leave the three ball in the middle of that rail. Thank you. Oh my gosh. Okay, still waking up. What do you say, Joe? You're in the same spot you were a minute ago. Maybe the four does go. Maybe it goes to the side. Safety. I couldn't play this guy. It would be torture for me. I can play anybody, but I would have to, very nice kick. I would have to seriously tell myself to be patient. My first chat room visitor, want to shoot like SVB. Good morning to you, sir or ma'am. Good morning, pool creatures. The six ball looks covered. It's covered by the eight. Watch the hit, boys and girls. Very nice hit. Double kiss in the corner. What a hit. Wow, same shooter. Wait, did he actually play that as a bank? Or did he miss the side? I missed that shot. I'm sorry, guys. He played the bank. Game two to Joe. Check on the floor, maybe.
Underneath the table.
These guys are just looking for the rack.
Good thing that wasn't a snake.
Wow. Thank you. Nice shot. Sorry, that gotta pay me extra for that.
You want my contribution?
Yeah. Well, you bring up a good point. Tony Rapone's asking me to put his match on. Huh? Good? Oh, yeah, I know. Okay, these players are going to take a quick break. Well, Gary Onimura and Tony Rapone are in a match, and they're like totally good friends. Tony hangs out at good times, like religiously, goes there all the time. By the way, you know, Tiger's new, have you guys seen Tiger's new case? It's a beautiful case, guys. Nylon and leather. It's got a very rugged look to it. And it also is very rugged. It's the perfect case to take when you're traveling. It's a great case to take from room to room. I have one personally myself. It's got three compartments for all of your gear. Fine leather work. And the case is just released. This year. So check out Tiger products and check out the Tiger case. If anybody wants to find out about the new Tiger case, contact me at daniel@povpool.com. Check 1, 2. Nobody told me my audio was down. You guys like me that much, huh? It's because no one's watching. Shh. Yeah, we got 32 people, man. 32 of you guys watching. You couldn't tell me my audio was down. Joe. You guys like the silence, huh? Okay. Let's see how you are. Let's see where you guys are going with this. Oh, I'm good. Want to shoot like SVB? Oh, thanks. I'm good now. Yeah. So you mean you heard everything I was talking about before? I'm gonna give you a quiz. Okay, so Jason has tied up the games. 2-2, right?
2-2.
3-2. Oh, 3-2. Whoops. Lost track. Lordy, lordy, lordy. Uh-oh. Why is it the table's only slow when you're going to get shape, but it's always fast whenever you shoot towards a corner pocket or any side pocket? I just don't get it. Yeah. Anyway, ball in hand. Joe's up 3-2. Good combo. This table's open. I mean, maybe it could get weird on the sixth ball. I don't know. Let's see. Weird on the three ball.
Hey, you want to buy a jump cue?
Believe it or not, my jump cue didn't fill up last night.
Yeah, that's the one you gave us.
Yeah.
How's that comeback coming along, Tony?
I almost got
good. Tony's coming back. Just a quick POV update for you. Safety battle. All right, so that was a smart way to play that shot. You don't want to do anything crazy, you know, like try to go around three rails or anything. I like to follow this ball because there is a little bit of angle. Oh my goodness. What's happening? By the way, just to remind you, the nine ball is called pocket, so if he'd have gotten lucky on that nine ball, the nine ball would have spotted back up. So oh, that eight ball wiped its feet on the way in. Is he looking at the side? I might just shoot the side pocket. I think the side is... Whoa! Three games apiece. Remember, it's a 7-6 race, so... Jason. Jason Osborn is technically ahead by a game. Okay, table's kind of looking a little wacky now. Good, man. Hey, we got Chris Stanfield. He just stepped in, and he had to leave early yesterday, but he played really well, man. How you doing?
Good. How you doing?
Good, good. Are you, you know, you stayed on the winner's side, right?
Yeah, I won my last match. I got fortunate, played good, and luckily, and just happened to come out ahead, you know.
But you had to leave early, right? Did you play all of your matches?
No, I luckily they were real cool about it, and I had to leave a little early because I did have to work. You know, just started a new job, so got to make sure that comes first. But Tim was real cool. He's running a great tournament, and can't thank him enough for everything he's doing.
That's great, man. And you want to say hi to moms?
Yep. Hi to my family out there. Hope you're all doing well, and I love you guys.
Where are they staying at?
Redlands, California. San Bernardino.
Yeah. Oh, all right. That's cool. I got to go up there. I've never visited. Is it nice up there?
Oh, yeah. Beautiful. Yeah, other than the crazy stuff that just happened, yeah, I miss it.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, so, yeah, you know, I miss it, but, you know, everything happens for a reason. I'm out here, you know.
You've been living in Vegas for a while, haven't you, Chris?
About 4 years, yeah, you know. Met you about 3 years ago.
Yeah, that's true. Well,
it's great to see you, too.
Thank you, man. It's... I'm really happy to see you, and you know what? Your game is, like, really solid right now.
Thank you, Daniel. Appreciate it.
No, I mean, that because I know when I've seen you play before on at Pool Sharks and here, you know, but you always had talent, but now you just seem a lot more focused. What have you been doing different?
I guess maturing, you know, getting healthier, you know. Trying to work on my game. Have a table at the house now where I'm at, and just been practicing a little more and more, and, you know, just a good workout regimen and just being healthy, I think, has given me an overall better consistency, you know. So that, and, you know, I mean, you're doing it. Exactly. It's fun again. You know what I'm saying? I have a job now, so I don't have to rely on it as much. It becomes, you know, a little more fun than it was. I mean, not that it's never been fun. It's always been fun, but... you know, it's just great now because I don't have to rely on it as, you know, like a income or a source, you know. So that's, you know, a big thing. But, yeah, you know.
That's awesome. Yeah, I mean, you actually bring up a good point. A lot of people, you know, they feel like this is more of a game than a sport. But if you really want to be, like, good at this game, you have to treat it like a sport, you know. And that requires a lot of maturing, you know, being mature and focused.
You know.
Taking it seriously in a way.
You know, you could see nine balls usually, I'm not going to say it's not for all ages, but you do see a lot of the younger guys playing the nine ball, and a lot of the older guys playing one pocket, slower pace, more of a moves, but then that kind of tells you something. You know, one pocket is more of a knowledgeable, you know, moving type of game, to where nine balls, you know, just a fire fest.
Like a gunslinger's game.
Exactly, you know, and so, I mean, you know, but pool, I'll tell you what, like... anybody that plays this game and everybody that plays good and play, you know, does their thing, they didn't just wake up one day with you know, able to do it. You know, they put a lot of time, a lot of effort. And I'll tell you what, this is probably, other than golf, I would say probably the hardest, and I do call it a sport, hardest sport in the world. You know, there's always, you know, you're never gonna have the same layout. You know, it's always, you know, it's a field game. You know, if you happen to, you know, not feel well that day, you know what I'm saying? You don't have a team to rely on like a lot of other sports.
Yeah, you kind of are on your own.
Right, you're in your own mind, you know. You got to have mental, you know, toughness. You know, just everything about it, you know, I love it, you know. And I'll tell you what, it kept me out of a lot of trouble at a young age. I can tell you that much, so.
What do you mean young age, man? What are you, like 24?
I'm going on 52. No. No.
How old are you?
Just turned 30, December 4th.
Oh, you're 30. Oh, man, you don't look 30.
Yeah. Thank you, man. Appreciate it. But.
Well, good, man. Yeah. Thanks for coming in, Chris.
Thank you so much. You're doing a great job, and love you being back out here doing the stream. You always do a great job, and, you know, I want to thank Tim Kovacs. He's doing awesome. I can't believe I just told him. I can't believe I was getting such a big turnout with such a high, I wouldn't say high entry, but, you know, a lot of people at you know, different levels, amateur levels, they don't want to necessarily, you know, pay the 50 or 60, you know, with the side pot as well. They like to keep it at $20, $10 weekly range, and they're doing it, and he's getting a great tournament. And this is a second event. I can't say, you know, enough of how great he's doing, you know.
And this is a whole tour too, you know. So we expect to see you at more of these too.
You know, it's going to be tough because I do work on the weekends, but as long, you know, he's working with me, and as long as he could do that, you know, and I don't, you know, upset anybody in the process of doing it, I'm going to be here. I love it. And win, draw, lose, whatever, it's just a great time.
It's cool, man. I'll be sure to be following the rankings, man. I'll try to get out to do a couple more of these.
Yeah, please. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you. Chris Stanfield is back on the map, and he's playing good. I'm sure we'll be seeing him today in a match on our live stream table. I would not be surprised if he ends up. He's definitely one of the favorites to win this event. Him, you know, the higher rated players are a lot of favorites, but, you know, this is a handicapped event, so... some of the lesser skilled players, they do have a chance. They really do. Look at Schmitty. He's playing with five games against Gary Onimura. Gary Onimura is one of the favorites, too. Already knocked to the one loss side. Gary gets to play a lot of pool, though. You know, he owns a pool hall. We think he's an action junkie. We think he may need help. We think he may need help. So I may have missed a game on this scoreboard here. I'm not sure, but I have a score of 4-3, and I did see Jason get a little emotional earlier on that last rack. Another tough layout. Doesn't look like the three passes the seven to the corner. He's going to play safety. It's funny how in a match with this format where there's no three foul rules, wow. He played it. Played it with no three foul rule. You wouldn't expect somebody like Joe to play a game like this with, you know, all this tactical play, all these difficult layouts. I'd hate to play him with a three foul rule. Let's just put it that way. Thank you.
Tournament to good times.
April 2nd, 3rd. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So you gonna be there?
I don't know. I don't know. We're still working it out with Tim. Okay. Yeah. I'd love to do it because I like Gary's venue.
Yeah, he's a nice, very nice.
But right now it's like I can't afford to come out. I can't afford to come out.
Where are you living?
Yeah.
No way, where at?
Los Angeles. Studio
wow,
City.
Nice. No way.
Yeah.
I love it.
It's a grind, man. It's expensive, yeah. Damn, but it's great. It's great. Oh, someone did ask about you, yeah. Do you remember who?
Ryan Chen? Oh, yeah, my boy from Mullen Heights.
Give him a shout out.
Yeah.
Give him a
shout out. He's listening?
Hey,
what's up? Oh, okay. If Brian Chen's out there, what's up, buddy? I haven't seen you in a while. Miss you. Hope everything's going great. Holding it down for Rolling Heights still. And I'll be out there soon. We have to hook up, man. Give me a call.
That's awesome, dude.
Chris Stanfield. Hey, you got a nickname yet or what?
No, in California, they used to call me Gilligan. Because when I was like 16, I'd be out at the pool room. And, of course, you know, I like to stay late with all the guys, even though I was young. Didn't have a car. So, come closing time, 2 a.m., I'm asking everybody for a ride. So, Alex from Styx, he gave me the nickname Gilligan because I was always stranded.
Oh, Alex, yeah. Yeah.
Mani Nong.
Yeah. Well, you got to come out. If you ever come out to Cali, I'll get you some action.
Okay. I haven't been gambling, but I mean, I've just been kind of.
Tournaments or whatever.
Yeah, tournaments for sure.
You know, we got the, you know about the West Coast Swing?
Yeah, the Mez, right?
No, West Coast Swing. It'll be the Cole Dixon tournament in San Francisco on July 2nd and 3rd. And then the very next weekend is the West Coast Challenge, which is 10,000 added 10 ball and 5,000 added one pocket. That's a 5-day event in Fremont, which is just south of San Francisco.
5 days?
Yeah.
Oh, for both.
For both. And then right after that is the hard times 10 ball, 5,000 added hard times 10 ball.
Wow. That is awesome.
Yeah. So it's three weekends in a row going from north to south, California.
Wow. When's the date?
July 7th. It's all July.
Oh, okay.
You
so
could
BCA time.
Yeah. Go to my website. It's all timed to happen right before the BCA.
Okay. All right. Yeah. I'll definitely do that. If I can get the time off, I would love to.
Yeah, that's why they call it the West Coast Swing, because it starts up north and then it swings out to Las Vegas.
Okay. They're going to have it out here?
July 2nd and 3rd is when it starts.
Okay. Yeah.
And it's going to be all California and then swing over to Las Vegas for the BCA Nationals.
Okay. Wonderful. Yeah, I'll definitely try to.
Yeah, just check out my website. You'll see the schedule there on the 2016 events unveiled. And then we'll be doing more promotion on the West Coast Swing. But if you can play any of those tournaments, find a sponsor or something.
Yeah, dude, I would love to.
Maybe get a room or somebody to sponsor you.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. The only thing that would be difficult would be the time off because I just started.
That's true. So, where are you working at?
Caesar's Palace.
Oh, nice, man. What are you doing there?
Surveillance.
You got to be kidding me.
I swear. Yeah. It's awesome. Great company. Love everybody I work with. You know, can't say, you know. I was over at the Super
Bowl. They do like what's the background checks like for that stuff?
They only hire crazy people. I'm just kidding. No, it's pretty intense. But I, you know, I was just very fortunate and blessed, and I am going full throttle with it.
Hold on, is this match over? Joe went to take a break. He's feeling sick. Okay.
Take me over. Tag me.
Chris Stanfield, everybody. Hopefully, we'll get him on the West Coast swing. We are waiting for Joe to come back. While we are waiting for Joe, please, once again, enjoy the beautiful new Tiger case.
Oh, those are nice.
Yeah. I have one, too, if you want to see it. Have you seen it?
I've seen it.
Yeah, okay. Hey, hold on a second. I'm going to get Tim Kovacs on the wire here. Tim, what's going on, sir?
Morning, Daniel.
Tim Kovacs is the co-tournament director and co-founder of this tour, the Sin City Tour. Really glad you could have us out here. And it's awesome that you're doing this for Vegas, man. This is cool.
Yeah, we're excited to have it going also. Wanted to thank a couple people. Tony from Tiger Products. Mike Halmer from Pool Tools. Tony from Hustlin' USA Clothing. Marty from Cravings Restaurant. And Tom and Irene, of course, from Dealer's Choice for all they've done. Those are our sponsors for this stop.
Yeah, Hustlin' USA, they've been in business quite a long time, and we're really happy to have them on board. Pool Tools, Mike Halmer, he's in Germany, isn't he?
Yes, out of Germany.
Yeah, and he's got a few things under his sleeve that he's going to be kind of releasing over the next year as well, right?
Yeah, exactly. That bridge hand, those custom bridges are really neat.
We're waiting on the website.
Telescope. Yeah, he's working on that right now.
Okay.
But love those custom chalkers. And Zach, first and second in this also gets a prize package from Mike Halmer.
From Mike Halmer?
Yeah,
okay.
A custom cue holder and chalker with their name engraved on it. The champion will say Tour Stop Champion on there.
Okay.
And they also get a custom bridge with their name engraved okay. on it also.
And Cravings Restaurant. Now, they're just over on Charleston, right?
Yeah, they're just right over there, a little health food place, really good food. They got great wraps and salads and all kinds of stuff. We did all kinds of drawings. We gave some stuff away from them, from all the sponsors. They were all awesome. Every one of them gave a ton of stuff away. I mean, we must have gave away $500 worth of free prizes. Just for your entry, you got a raffle ticket. We just did raffles.
Okay, cool.
Cool. Matter of fact, we're getting ready to do another one here right now soon.
That's great, man. That's good. Yeah, you've been doing raffles all day yesterday. You were doing the raffle drawings and stuff. That's cool. It's really good. It's important for these companies to step up and contribute, you know, and it helps to promote them and gives you guys some awareness of, you know, high-quality products so that you can improve your pool games.
Yeah, it's been exciting too. It's just something different. We just kind of decided to just reached out and asked a couple of them, hey, we wanted to try to do this, and we kind of got the idea from the fundraiser tournaments and doing that. And I figured I'd reach out to some of these companies and ask them, and haven't had one person say no yet. They've just all been more than happy to give, you know, to give back to the players and to give back to Vegas.
Okay. Well, then, good luck with Microsoft and Apple. And
right. Yeah, let me go hit them up. Then we could get some real money.
Just give a shout out to Nike, you know. So.
Just do it.
Yeah, yeah. So you got any interesting things to say about the next venue coming up, Good Times Billiards, April 2nd and 3rd?
Yeah, we'll be back at Good Times. Very excited to head that way. Of course, it's a beautiful venue. It's non-smoking in the pool room, so
yeah.
That's a bit different.
Yeah. With a full bar on the other side.
Yes, full bar on the
poker
other side.
Machines and all that.
Exactly. And, being in Vegas, most bars are all bars are smoking. And so it's nice to have the one where there's no smoking for me. Anyways.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah,
being
yeah.
A non-smoker.
Yeah. You know what? I'm a smoker and I can't handle too much smoke all the time.
Yeah, these little bars get pretty cloudy, you know, and when you can't see across the bar, it's...
It's true. It's true.
We got a good match going on here, huh?
Yeah. Joe's been playing a pretty tactical, you know, kind of strategy, soft break and keeping the balls down at the bottom of the table. But now, as you can see, this last break, he broke them pretty hard. He's kind of his confidence has built, I guess, and he feels like changing gears a little bit. That's kind of what he's doing.
The table's wide open here.
Table is wide open.
I know both these guys well. They're both my practice partners. So,
well, Jason won the This is Jason's opportunity. Jason won the Doc Hill, didn't he, this last year, didn't he? And he got the next one coming up.
2015 Doc Hill champion.
Well, I bet that got him a lot of action, huh?
He was in it for a minute this year again, and they kind of nixed that idea. They took him out. They're going to make him sit a year.
He's not allowed to play it. What about Jeff Gray? Is he allowed to play it?
Jeff Gray's still on the list, so he'll be in it. Because
he came
wait.
In second, right?
Yeah, he came in second. He knocked me out last year. You know, I knocked him out the year before, and he knocked me out last year. So I'm looking for revenge this year.
Oh, okay. So yeah, you're a pretty good pool player too. You're very involved with the leagues out here as well. No way. He's pissed. That's going to put Joe on the hill.
Yeah, that's a.
He's mad. That's the second rack he choked in a row.
It happened. We know that. That's for sure. I love how you have the logos bouncing around up there. That's great, man.
Oh, thanks,
I really
man.
Like that, you know.
That's how we do it.
Right?
Look at him. He's not even, he doesn't even care anymore. He's mad. I hope he's not like upset. Maybe we're bothering him. I don't know. We're not talking that loud.
No, I don't think it's us. I'm going to head on over there and let you handle this stuff here.
Okay. Tim, it's great to see you, man. Thank
Always
you.
Always good to see you, brother. Can't wait for the next one.
Yeah, man. April 2nd and 3rd at Good Times. And by the way, let's drop your email and phone number so that the people who are watching can contact you so that they can sign up and enter the events.
Okay. On our Tiger Facebook page, all that info is on there. But mine is the number 9, ballrollin@gmail.com. And my number is 702-234-5729.
That's right. And if you're friends with Christy Lips, you can contact Christy Lips as well. And that also counts for all you other interested sponsors out there that want to get involved with this Tiger Sin City Tour. Thanks again, Tim.
All right. Thank you, brother.
All right, buddy. Keep up the good work. Tim Kovacs. He's the man. Man with the plan doing the Tiger Sin City Tour. Meanwhile, oh, I see Adam Roberts just arrived. Mr. Adam Roberts. Joe's two railing this five ball. Looks like it wants to go, but it's going to slow down. So Jason has a chance to do something here. You know, it is not impossible to win four games in a row. Actually, he only needs three games. I mean, it's not unheard of to do that. Adam Roberts. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good afternoon.
How you doing?
Pretty good.
Yeah.
How you doing?
I'm doing okay. I got about 4 hours sleep, so I'm all right. Yeah. So I heard you had a tough match yesterday with Paul Gauthier.
Oh yeah. Yeah. He played very, very good. I made a couple of mistakes. He capitalized and he won. So it was late. We finished up about 1:15 or so.
Yeah, we were just exhausted.
Everybody was gone. I was the last one to leave besides Christy and Tommy Lips.
Yeah, for us it was like a 14-hour day.
It was a long day yesterday. Yeah.
So I'm trying to be cool here because Jason Osborn is getting very upset. He's choked two games in a row. He hung the 9 in the last game. And he has a chance to win, you know, right now. But, I mean, he's just got to get his head together, you know.
Yeah, that's a bank that I would expect Jason to make.
You know, he's just he's been mad, like, physically. I mean, visibly, noticeably upset for some reason.
Wow. That's unlike him. He's pretty good about keeping his cool, pretty low-key kind of guy.
Yeah, he's usually pretty even keel, from what I can tell. Well, Adam, welcome back. I thought you were sleeping in today, but apparently you were up and at him early.
Yeah, I was doing some other pool activities, not the pool that we were watching here, but the swimming pool. I had to work on the filters and the pump and stuff like that. So.
Wait, you don't have an account with Neptune Pools?
No. You know, that's where I got the filters from.
Okay, from Ryan.
Yeah, from Ryan. And the funny thing is that when I have some issues like that, I think he's only been by the house one time. I usually fix them myself. Yeah, you know, he's busy. He's got a very busy business and stuff like that. So to get him to come by is a challenge.
Yeah, I would imagine. I think he was working on Max Eberle's pool like a few years ago, a little bit, when they started to become friends, you know. But he just came over a couple times.
As a matter of fact, he's working today. He's got two clients that he said that called in and have some leaks, so he's got to go work on those. It's probably where he is right now.
Well. I'm assuming somehow Jason won that last game. Unless I miscalculated here, maybe now it's 6-3. Joe goes to 7 and Jason goes to 6. I was talking to you, so I didn't see who won that game. Maybe the chat room can help me who actually won that game because it looked like Joe was going to win it. It's cool, man. You know, it's just setting in that this is actually a tour, you know, like you guys are going to be doing this event again, April 2nd and 3rd. This will be over at Good Times. So it's kind of cool. You know, it's like a chance for you guys to like compete for $1,000 first prize every time they do a tour stop.
Yeah, it's looks like it's working out pretty good. There's been, you know, a few issues with some scheduling and stuff yesterday. And how they were doing the bringing people back into today, and hopefully they get that sorted out, worked out, so that doesn't happen again. And they just keep making it better. I definitely think that both Tim and Christy have all intentions on improving it every time, every chance that they get. So
it'll be nice too if we can see a couple more sponsors step up or something. You know, maybe we can. Add a little more money to the prize funds. Be nice. Vegas definitely has a thriving kind of active pool scene.
Absolutely. And, you know, the players locally here in Vegas have been strung out a little bit with, you know, not not being able to have decent money tournaments on a regular basis because of a lack of sponsors and stuff. You know, they get, we play in tournaments and we put the money in, and then what happens is usually the tournament directors are taking money out. So
like a rake.
Right. So, you know, or green fee and, you know, different types of fees, and then the payouts aren't that good, you know? So it's, there's a lot of players that voice their frustration about that. So, but it is what it is. So this, obviously more money is making more people happy. So
it's good. That is good. And in a way, you know, just stepping up the entry fee is important. You know, you need a little higher entry fee in order to fluff up the prize fund a little bit.
Yeah, that, and it also steps up the competition too, you know.
And a side pot.
Yes, so there's a lot of people that have, you know, $70 invested in this tournament for this weekend. You know, and there's some people that, you know, don't want to do that on a regular basis. So, you know, they might not make every tour stop, but there's a lot of people that are excited about it and that do want to see this and attend every single one of these. So I've been hearing some pretty good feedback.
Well, I don't see why not. You know, the competition's good. I mean, it doesn't seem to be this is a handicap event, so everybody's kind of got a fair chance. I mean, you guys in Vegas, you guys have been working on the Vegas ratings now for years. I mean, you pretty much know everybody's ratings, so matching up is not lopsided like 90% of the time. It's pretty fair.
It is pretty fair. It is. You know, you always get the complainers and the people that feel like they're
That's just gonna happen.
Absolutely, but you know what? It is what it is. So, there's, you know, a very few people that you know, kind of boycott that kind of rating system and they refuse to be part of it. But
there's actually several. There's two or three types of ratings here in Vegas, aren't there? There's the new Vegas Pool Action rating system that you guys have been doing.
Right. That's the 9-foot table, nine ball. That's basically strictly that.
And that's been from the big table format.
Right. It's the big table format. And it's kind of basic. And that was kind of derived from, and creating that list was derived from the Las Vegas rating system.
Right. And then there's the Las Vegas rating system, which has been sort of just developed over years.
Well, it was originally developed here in Las Vegas by Mark Estes. And then when Amy Kane took over and started doing Vegas Billiard Buzz, she kind of took that rating system over and kind of headed it up. Now she's not doing, she's still doing Vegas Billiard Buzz, but she's not as in depth with it as she used to be because now she works for CSI.
Sure.
So she is actually no longer going to be doing the Vegas rating system. Matter of fact, I think she's not doing it now.
Right, because the CSI is on Fargo.
Correct. Yeah. So she's she has a it's not really a tour, but she has tournaments, Las Vegas tournaments here that she's been doing for years, and it was based off the Las Vegas ratings.
Yeah.
Now she's basing it all off of Fargo.
Okay, so Joe has closed out this match. Final score of 7-4. Thank you to you guys in the chat room for helping us with the score. I've been talking to a few different people here. This is Adam Roberts. He's a Las Vegas pool player, and he's been also sort of like a video engineer here for the Tiger Sin City Tour. He did the first stream. Well, he did a live stream for them last month, and he's probably going to be doing a couple of these tour stops.
Yeah, I'll be doing the next one over at Good Times on April 2nd and 3rd, and that'll be on Vegas Pool Action.